another time.
Ben, now you can survive the journey back to Firenze. Oh! I do not recall such brave talk at Monteriggioni. Rodrigo surrounds himself with snakes and murderers. Even his daughter, Lucrezia, has been shot in one of his most artful rages. But she pays for the man behind the villa attack. He is ambitious, ruthless, and cruel beyond imagining. The laws of men mean nothing. He murdered his own brother to take power. He knows neither danger nor fatigue. Those who do not fall by his sword clamor to join the ranks. Powerful Orsini and Colonna families have been brought to kneel.
Cesare, head of the papal armies.
What does he intend to do with his power? What drives the man?
That I still do not know. But Ezio.
Cesare has set his sights on all of Italia, and at this rate he will have it. He knows how to exercise his will. A rare virtue in the world today.
Pezzi di merda!
Do you have some kind of plan?
Please come,
Mr. Lord.
You excel at opening wounds, Ezio. But can you also close them? Stop sparring with me. I am inclined to disagree. Are you suggesting we appeal to the people? Relying on the people is like building on the sand. I will wait at the Campidoglio. I am meeting a contact there. I merely describe the reality of Roman today. But all may not be lost. The good news is that we have allies. How much longer this will last, however, I cannot say.
Find me at the tournament.